I think it is no secret that many people dream of living near the coast overlooking the Azure Ocean. But unfortunately, in some areas it is not as easy as it seems, because it is influenced by several factors: the cost of housing, location, and history of the area. It was the same in Land's End, UK. Elizabeth Strutton, a long period of hard work and faced with emotional burnout, stress, and constant worries, pushed her to a step that changed her life forever. The girl wanted to live on the coast, but it was difficult for her to find a property that matched her financial possibilities and needs. But she knew exactly what she needed was a place where she could relax from the hustle and bustle of the city and be happy, in one with nature. That's why she really wanted her own place to live in the Land's End, because it's a rocky cape in the southwest of Britain with charming scenery and fresh sea air. Once she was looking through real estate ads in the area, and at one of the services, she saw an unusual object. She came across a bunker from World War II, which was decommissioned, and at the same time, she had an idea. The bunker was built in 1942 and was used during the war as a communication point. After the end of the war, the bunker remained untouched for a long time, and the farmer who owned the object used it to store potatoes until it was noticed by Elizabeth. Buying the future house together with the plot cost her £140,000. It took Elizabeth a whole 5 years and another £100,000 to turn it into a cozy home. The seller only smiled at the deal, not understanding why the girl was involved in this adventure. But as Elizabeth herself says, this bunker could resist the bomb explosion, and its direct purpose is to save lives. And it would be right if he coped with the task and saved mine. Elizabeth has spent a lot of energy and time to turn this bunker into a comfortable 3-room house. In general, the bunker was in very bad condition. It had a lot of original equipment left over from the war, but none of it worked. On the walls, there were power supply units and electronics that were once used. Now there is electricity and water in the house because this object is connected to the central system. On the roof of her bunker house, Liz installed panoramic windows to penetrate daylight because the windows in the bunker is not. On the side of the house is still invisible. Elizabeth now has a private entrance to the house, a garden, garage, barn, and excellent views of the open countryside and the ocean. After the renovation is complete, the house has a full living room, a huge kitchen, 2 bathrooms, and 3 beds. The bathroom once had a ventilation unit, which worked 24 hours a day, and now it also provides air circulation. The whole process of repair the girl controlled personally and took part in it. She chose light and warm wall colors and modern lighting so that she always had a warm mood. The kitchen was made to meet the needs of the girl, where she can show her culinary fantasies. There is no trace of the gray walls of this historic place. This is how one of the bedrooms looks. All furniture was made of real wood at Elizabeth's request. And so it looks. The workplace of Liz. Working remotely, she loves to go out and look at the ocean with a cup of coffee. One bathroom is made in blue, the ocean color, which surrounds her new home. Elizabeth told us why she wanted to live here. This is a magical castle. It is like another world. It is a living story. At first I was worried and thought about what I got into. Many people said that I wouldn't succeed, but now I know it is the best place on earth. Now I can work in my house, and the daily walk on the shore of the ocean with the taste of fresh sea air on my lips give me strength. I would never trade this house for another one. Friends, what do you think?